Black women, we need to step up. And part of stepping up is stepping up for ourselves.
That's beautiful.
Not just everybody else.
I feel like you've been on a personal journey. You go on your Instagram and like you were traveling, you know.
Yeah.
You turned 50 and I'm like, where? It's just
right here.
Gray is like sexy though, you know?
You know what? I'm loving my gray. I had a moment with it. And it's funny, the gray has freed me. Because like playing with hairstyles to this level, I've never done that. I've been very fortunate with my wash and go hair, and I've just been rocking that all kind of ways. But this has made me, look at my lip. I don't wear bright lip. This is not me. But, well, it wasn't me. It's me now. It's 50. I feel like I'm a little backwards. I was a breech baby, so maybe I do everything backwards. But I'm now like all the, you know, playing with makeup, playing with hairstyles, to your point, traveling. Approaching 50, but I will have to say it was around Alton Sterling and Philando Castile's death, right after Sandra Bland's death, right around that time. I'm a very optimistic person. But I was like, oh, this is depression. I was like, okay, I don't sit still long enough maybe to get, but I was going there. My husband wrote this beautiful piece. He put it in, I think it was the Hollywood Reporter, but the anecdote to dying is living. And I looked at my list of dreams and hopes and goals, and I was like, what am I not doing? What am I going to be upset about that I did not try in this lifetime? And I started doing those things. And I think that's one of the spaces I want, and travel is a big part of it. I've always wanted to go to Thailand, and I actually really promote solo travel. Mm-hmm. Especially as a writer, it just opened me up all these things I wanted to do, these callings in us are our spirit, right? And if we don't start answering those calls, it's going to choke us. It's going to kill us. It's going to hurt us. And so I started slowly and then fast paced answering the calls to my spirit. Mm-hmm. And I really feel renewed at 50. I think 50 also puts you in that, like people say, what, the midlife crisis? I would say the midlife celebration. And I'm doing that, and it's involved, like I said, it involves travel, it involves hair changes, it involves lipstick, it involves, oh, red nails. I was never a red nail girl. I mean, it involves.
That's surprising, because you're a Delta. You would think that
I am. I am. It's funny, but I just was playing it soft, playing it subtle, and it's like,
It looks good, though. I love it.
Thank you. These are my grandmother's nails. But the bigger point I'm trying to make is it is time to live. And I think it's in line with what I've been trying to say on my stories to Black women. Accept ourselves, love ourselves, dust ourselves off, and go keep living. Because I think when the world treats Black women the way that we can eventually treat ourselves, which is the queens that we are, but to match our energy about how much we give to the world, if the world treats us that way, I mean, then the axis will spin right again. Earth will be a place, we'll get right again. Black women, we need to step up, and part of stepping up is stepping up for ourselves.